ചന്ദ്രതുണ്ടമഹാകായം സൂര്യകോടിസമപ്രഭ നിർവിഘ്നം കുരു മേ ദേവ സർവകാര്യേഷു സർവദാ സരസ്വതി നമസ്തുഭ്യം വരദേ കാമരൂപിണി വിദ്യാരംഭം കരിഷ്യാമി സിദ്ധിർഭവതു മേ സദാ സാക്ഷാത് കൃതം ദയാനന്ദം പരമാർത്ഥസ്വരൂപിണം തത്വജ്ഞാന പ്രശാസ്താരം പ്രണതോസ്മി പരം പദം യേനാക്ഷര സമാംനായം അധിഗമ്യ മഹേശ്വരാത് കൃഷ്ണം വ്യാകരണം പ്രോക്തം തസ്മൈ പാണിനയേ നമഃ വാക്യകാരം വരരുചിം ഭാഷ്യകാരം പതഞ്ജലിം പാണിനിം സൂത്രകാരം ച പ്രണതോസ്മി പരം പ്രണതോസ്മി മുനിത്രയം വാഗർഥാവിവ സംപൃക്തൗ വാഗർഥപ്രതിപത്തയേ ജഗതഃ പിതരോ വന്ദേ പാർവതീ പരമേശ്വരോ സഹനാഭവതു സഹനൗ ഭുനക്തു സഹ വീര്യം കരവാവഹൈ തേജസ്വിനാവധീതമസ്തു മാ വിദ്വിഷാവഹൈ ഓം ശാന്തി ശാന്തി ശാന്തിഃ. You know all the shlokas what we chant, but I'm not showing it in my screen. It is only in the PowerPoint, not in this PDF. The order of the shlokas what we chant, starting from Akratunda, then Saraswati Namastubhyam, then Guru Namaskara, Takshat Kutum Dayanantam. Then we chant Enakshara Samamnayam. That's an important shloka. Akshara Samamnayam. That we will see soon in our class. What is Akshara Samamnayam? That is Maheshwara Sutra. That is called Akshara Samamnayam. And the next shloka is Vakyakaram Vararuchim. That is shloka offering namaskara to all the three munis, munitrayam. Then vagartha vivasam prutta, that meaning of that shloka we saw, namaskara to jagatav pitarav, the father and the mother of the jagat. Then finally we chant sahanabhavatu shanti mantra. So this is the order. You can if you don't know this shloka, you can memorize these shlokas. So this is, these are the shlokas we chant. Okay, I'm not showing it that in the screen, so I hope you will remember it. Okay. If you have any problem in reading and chanting that shloka, you can tell me. At the end of the class, you can tell me which shloka. I'll teach you that. So you would have gone through the PDF file, what I sent. Did you go through that?
Yes, Sharanji.
Okay. Others also can say something. Did you go to the PDF file if you have any doubts up to the last page, what we saw? If you have any doubts or any difficulty, you can tell me. Do you have any doubts or any difficulty? Please unmute your mic. Your mic is in mute.
This is Nagaraj here. I am okay until now. There is no okay. problem.
So far no issues. This is Venkateshwaran.
Okay.
So far so good, Sharanji. This is Shyam.
Okay. So if you have doubts, you have to ask me. Then only I can clarify the doubts. If If you have any doubts or difficulties, right? So if you don't have any doubts, then we'll move on. Okay. Fine. So, but I feel some students still in the class, they have difficulty in reading. So therefore, we will do some more reading practice. Then we will get into the level 2. It's quickly we will read. So those who are comfortable, they can read quickly. Let us see how others read. So today we will look at the list of words, what is given at the end of the book. We'll go through that quickly. We'll try to complete the remaining part of the book today itself. We'll find some words given, some nouns are given in all the three genders, masculine, feminine, and neuter. Before we go through that, please enter your name in the chat box if you have not entered. So I will call the name from the chat box and they will read. Okay. In Sanskritam, the gender of a word, please listen carefully. The gender of a word in Sanskritam is not determined by the meaning of the word. I'm giving a negative definition. It's not a definition, negative interpretation. Suppose if I ask you, what is the gender of the word tree? Tree in English. What is the gender? Tree is, it's a neuter gender, right? What is the gender of the word wife? Wife, what is the gender in English? Feminine gender. Because in English, we go by the meaning of the word. Wife means must be a woman. Assuming that the marriage is between a man and a woman. Okay. So that we have to assume nowadays. So therefore, wife means the meaning of the word wife. We are taking the meaning. So it's a woman, therefore, feminine gender. Man, husband. Husband is a masculine gender. Husband is the man. And tree. Tree is a neuter gender. Okay. But in Sanskritam, it is not like that. It cannot go by the meaning of the word. The words in Sanskritam, they have gender. That's it. The words of the Sanskritam have gender. Its gender doesn't depend on the meaning. The word has gender. That's it. And say, for example, tree. Tree is neuter gender in English. Whereas in Sanskritam, it's a masculine gender. And similarly, the word wife. Wife is a feminine gender in English. And in Sanskritam, we have word for the wife in all the three genders. In all the three genders, we have word for wife. For example, all of you know maybe patni, bharya. It means wife. It's a feminine gender word. Bharya, patni. Generally, listen carefully. Feminine gender word ends with long vowel. In general, okay. This is not a hard and fast rule. It is not like that. In general, always exceptions will be there. Please underline. Exceptions will be there. In general, feminine gender words will end with long vowels. So, patni, bharya, this is feminine gender word. The word wife, it can be It can have word in neuter as well as masculine gender also. A neuter word for wife is kalatram. Kalatram means wife. It also means husband also. That is different. Kalatram means spouse, wife. It's a neuter gender word. And in masculine gender, and masculine also we have a word for wife. Dara. Dara is wife. So, for the word wife, we have for wife, we have words in all the three genders. So what I'm saying is the words in Sanskritam have gender, irrespective of the meaning. Then you may ask, how do you know the gender of the word? That you know when you learn the language, when you become familiarized with the language, when you get familiarization with the language over a period of time, then you know the gender. There is a grantha book written by Panini Magarishi on knowing the gender of the word. That's called Linga Anushasanam. We don't have to go through the text to understand, to know, you know, the gender of a word. When you learn the language, after some time you know the gender. You yourself will come to know the gender. It's easy. It's not difficult. So don't feel frightened.
What is the reason for Sanskrit?
There is no reason. There is no reason. That is how the language is.
But it's a little bit complicating. No,
it's not complicated. That's why I said no. We are looking. Yeah, we are looking at a language through some other language. That is not correct. Every language is unique. English is also complicated. For some people, they have still problem in speaking in English. We don't know. In fact, we also have problem in using the preposition. Where to use the right preposition? For example, the preposition in, in is there. When to use a word in or on? Still, no, we have problem. So there is no complication at all. That thought should not be there. That's why I'm giving an elaborate interpretation to this. There is no complication in it. Anything will become complicated only when we don't understand. But when you learn the language over a period of time, when you get to know the language, it becomes easy. Any language for that matter, it's complicated only if you don't know. Once you know, then it becomes easy. So it takes time, okay, to get to know the gender. That's why I said over a period of time, when you get familiarization with the language over a period of time, it will become easy, it will become clear. So yourself will understand how the words have gender. Now what you have to understand is the word has gender, irrespective of the meaning of the word. Don't look at the meaning of the word to identify the gender in Sanskrit. That must be clear. Yes, is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. So our general orientation is we always look at the meaning of the word and say whether the word is masculine, feminine, or neuter. That orientation should be knocked off when you learn Sanskrit. In fact, in other languages also like that, I think in other foreign languages, maybe French or Portuguese, maybe somebody said, I forgot which language is that.
Spanish has it.
Yeah, Spanish, yeah, exactly, Spanish, yes. It is like that, so it's not a problem. So now we will quickly go through the words. The words what I have given now, it's for you to practice. You should read and as well as try to remember the meaning. This is how you develop the vocabulary also. Later when we do some simple translations, these words will be useful. So we'll go through the words quickly. You can go through the words again and again so that you will remember. Right? That is the idea. So your vocabulary gets improved. So first I will ask Timurji, can you read the first five lines quickly with the meaning also?
Ajaha, goat. Ajagaraha, snake. Ashwaha horse. Adhyapakaha teacher. Anandaha happiness. Agamaha agamaha Vedas. Asandaha chair. Akashaha sky. Acharaha conduct. Alayaha temple.
Arakshakaha
police. Ishwaraha god. Urnanabha.
Urnanabha.
Urnanabha. Oshtaragaha lipstick.
Yeah. One minute. I enlarge the screen. The next word. Last one.
I didn't see Oshtaragaha lipstick. And then Apolaha.
Kapolaha.
Kapolaha.
Cheek. Cheek. Okay, fine. So you are at 5 lines now. So now if you go through the words now, starting from Ajaha, Ajaha, Ajagaraha, Ashvaha, Adhyapakaha. If you see the last word and all the words what you read now, what is that you feel? What is that the similarity? Urnanabha, Arakshaha, Arakshakaha, Acharaha, Asandaha, Akashaha. So
Visarga.
Visarga.
Visarga is
Pullingam.
No, it doesn't mean Visarga, I mean not Pullinga. Before Visarga.
They all end with
the letter A. Is then Visarga comes. That's different. That's different. Okay. That after A, Visarga comes. That's different. But all the words, they are ending with A only. Aja. Without the Visarga, I'm saying. Aja, Ajagara, Ashva, Adhyapaka, Ananda, Agama, Asanda, Akasha, Achara, Alaya, Arakshaka, Ishvara, Udanabha, Oshtaraga, Kapola. So, really speaking, this is a word. From this word only, you get Ajaha, Ajagaraha, Ashvaha, Adhyapakaha, Anandaha. The actual word is Aja only. From Aja, you get Ajaha. Actual word is Ajagara. Ajagara only, you get Ajagaraha. Similarly, actual word Ashva. From that only, you get Ashvaha. Adhyapaka. From that, you get Adhyapakaha. So, now looking at the actual noun, no, it is only without the Visarga. Aja, Ajagara, Ashva, Asanda, Akasha. So, if you look at that, it ends with the short vowel A. Right? Yes or no? Yes?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
The short vowel A. Therefore, masculine gender words. Masculine gender words in general, it will end with short vowels. What are the short vowels? A, E, U, R, L. So all these are short vowels. And also, consonants also will come. That we will see later. We don't have to get into that now. So you will find the words ending with short vowels. That most probably it will be masculine gender. This is the initial orientation. Later, slowly I will modify it. But now you understand this. The words what you see in these tables, they are singular. They are singular. Okay, they are singular. And the original form, if I can use the word original form of the word is aja, ajagara, ashva, without the visarga. That is the original form. It ends with a short vowel. Therefore, the words ending with the short vowels could be masculine gender. So this you can remember. So by this you can identify what gender is. Okay. So the word for masculine in Sanskrit is pullinga. What is that? Pullinga. Can remember that? Pullinga. You want me to type it? You understand it? Understand it? Okay. Okay. It's pullinga. I will type later. Okay. The word for masculine gender is pullinga. So the words what you are reading now, they are all pullinga. Pullinga shabdaha. Pullinga shabdaha. That's what I have written here. You can see shabdaha. Shabdaha is words. So pullinga shabdaha. This is what you are reading. Okay. So now the next person.
Sharanji, this is Nagraj here.
Yeah.
Just a question. The original form is aja. So does ajaha make any difference or is it?
Yes, we'll see that later. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. It's too early to say, talk about it. That's why I intentionally avoid certain things so that it will be, you know, it will avoid confusion. So,
sure. Thank you.
So we'll talk about that later. Yes. There's a difference. The original form is aja. From that, you get ajaha. Any word you take, that will be like that. Kapola. From kapola, you get kapolaha.
Okay.
So now the next set of words will be read by Seemaji. Can you read from the word torchlight? Is there sixth line? I think you can see that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kardipaha, torchlight. Kattipattaha.
Kattipattaha.
Kattipattaha. Then.
What is the original form? Kattipattaha.
Kattipatta.
Okay.
Kapiha.
Kapihi, not kapiha.
Sorry. Kapihi.
What is his original form?
Kapi.
Kapi ends with short vowel E. Therefore, masculine gender. Okay.
Kapotaha. Kupaha. Keshaha.
You can read the meaning also. Yeah, continue.
Karkataka.
Karkataha.
Karkataha. Crab.
Crab. Karkataka. Karkataka is the original form. And it's
Karmakaraha. Waka. Khajuraha. Dek.
Kharjuraha.
Okay. Kharjuraha. Dates. Gramaha. Village. Charmakaraha, cobbler. Chamasaha, spoon. Chashakaha, glass. Chalakaha, driver. Chitrakaraha, painter.
Okay, then stop here. So all the words. Now you can remember the, you can try to, you know the original form. So Karkataka, Karmakara, Charmakara, Karjura, all these words end with the short vowel A. Okay. So, masculine gender. Kapihi, Kapi, that Kapi is its original form, ends with E. So, from the original form only, we get these words. What is its original form and these? That we will see later. Okay. So we'll slowly know what it is. They say all the information, give you all the information now, that will be too much. That's why I avoid. So, you want to make your study simple and comfortable. So, I reserve certain information now. I'll tell you later. Okay. So, this much is enough now. Okay. Next person can read now. Bhuvaneshwariji. Can you read from the next line? Here, what you can do is you can try to remember the meaning of these words. And many of the words in our native language, you know, it's common. We know many of the words. Grama, we know. Grama means village. Gramaha. right? So other words you can slowly, you know, get familiar with that. Yeah, continue please.
Janakaha, father. Jalashayaha, pond. Tailapaha, cockroach. Dandadeepaha, tube light. Divaraha, fisherman. Nakulaha, mongoose. Nartakaha, dancer. Patihi, husband. Pachakaha, cook. Ballukaha, deer. Makaraha, crocodile. Lekaha, writer.
Lekakaha.
Lekaha.
No, Lekakaha.
Lekakaha.
Yeah.
Writer. Shalabaha, grasshopper. Shiraha, head. Shauchalayaha, toilet. Shalyaha, porcupine. Shrugalakaha. Shrugalaha.
Shrigalaha.
Shrigalaha. Jackal. Shambukaha, snake. Sahodaraha, brother. Sarpaha, snake. Sudakandaha, chalk piece.
Okay. I think you're right. So, when you come across these words, I mean English words, try to connect with these Sanskrit words. You have to keep reading, you know, then only you will know these words. And when we do translation, we will take words from these list of words, you know, we will do some translation so that you will slowly will be familiarity with these words. Okay, now the next person will read. Ganeshji, can you read from Ash Bhuvaneshwariji left?
Sahodaraha.
1 minute. Yeah.
Sahodaraha, brother. Tarpaha, snake. Sudakhandaha, chalk piece. Sukaraha, pig. Suvarnakaraha, goldsmith. Sevakaha, servant. Skandaha, shoulder. Thambaha, pillar. Harinaha,
okay. Fine, now the next person will read. So now you'll find the list of words in feminine gender. Shyamji, can you read?
Yeah. Amba, mother. Anuja, sister, younger sister. Agraja, elder sister. Apaga, river. Agnipetika, matchbox. Avakarika, dustbin. Anamika, ring finger. Uttitika, table. Kunchika, key. Javanika, curtain. Jihwa, tongue. Oven.
Okay, fine. Now, what is the difference between the words what you read now and the previous list of words? What's the difference you see? Find.
There are long vowels.
Long vowels.
So, this is also in singular. Okay. So, visarga also will come here if it is plural. That is different. But here, the original form, for example, if you take the word amba, amba is, its original form is amba only. Amba, and from amba only you get this amba. Both ambas are different. Why different? We will see later. Similarly, anuja. Anuja, original form is anuja. From that, you are getting anuja. Agraja, original form. From that, agraja, we get. If you see the ending of the original form of the word, it ends with long vowels. A, E, U, R, A, I, O, all these words. So the words ending with long vowels generally will begin feminine gender. When I say generally, it means there are exceptions. Exceptions are there. Okay. So in general, now we generally we know that much is enough now. At this level, general is enough. So when you come across a word ending with long vowel, understand it could be feminine gender. I'm giving a tip so that you can identify the gender of the word. If it ends with a short vowel, it is a masculine gender word. Ends with a long vowel, it could be a feminine gender word. That is a simple, conclusion at this level. Fine. Now the next person, Joji, can you read from the next line?
Churika, knife. Jetuka, bat. Janani, mother.
You say Janani, E is. So, E,
Janani.
Long vowel, E.
Nasika, nose. Pakashala, kitchen. Pipilika, ant. Putri, daughter. Balika, girl. Bharya, wife. Mapika, ruler. Madhumakshika, honeybee. Murdha, head. Mala, garlands. Lata, creeper. Lekhani, pen. Shatika, sari. Suta, daughter. Haimika, snow.
Okay, good. So we have seen now list of words in feminine gender. Now we will see words in neuter gender. Okay. So Shanta, Sundarji, can you read? Sundarji.
Asanam, feet. Abaranam, necklace. Alukam, potato. Amra phalam, mango. Udaram, stomach. Upadhanam, pillow. Kankanam, bangle. Kadali palam, banana. Karavastram.
Very good. Yeah.
Gunjanakam.
Gr. It is gr.
Sorry. Grinjanakam. Grinjanakam.
Yeah.
Carrot. Chibukam. Chin. Chatram. Umbrella. Jalam. Water. Dwaram. Door. Netram. Eye.
Okay. So you see the difference between masculine, feminine, and neuter words. So all the words in masculine we saw adhyapakaha, rukshaha, ashvaha, ajagaraha, and feminine gender amba, patni, javanika, mala, and in neuter it is asanam,
Kara.
Abharanam, alukam, kankanam. You can see the words ending with
makara.
Ending with the consonant. Makara is there. Okay. But the original word, say for example, the first word if you take, the word seat, the original word is asana. Asana is the original word. From that you get asanam. Similarly, abharana. From that you get abharanam. Aluka. From that alukam. Amra. Amrapala. We get amrapalam. From the word udara, we get Udaram. So here also ending with a only. Here also the words end with a only. Doesn't mean it is masculine gender. Okay, it doesn't mean it is masculine gender. It is neutral gender. From the original word, this form, asanam, abharanam, alukam, all these words are derived and it ends with makara. From the original word, after derivation, we get these words and we get makara at the end. So, from these words, we understand that the original word as the gender of the original word is neuter. From these words only we understand. From the derived word only we understand the gender of the original word. For example, when I say ajaha, when I say original word is aja. So from that aja only we got the word ajaha. So from the derived word we understand aja is a masculine gender. Similarly, mala is there. Mala is original. From that we get the form mala. Both forms are same. So it ends with long vowel. So we understand mala is a feminine gender. And here asanam, the word is there. Its original form is asana. But the derived form is asanam. From this we understand it is a neuter gender word. Okay. So if you don't know the gender of a word, from the derived form we can understand. Okay, so all these what you see are the derived form from the original word. I use Hello. Original derived now. Later that also I will drop. I will use some other word. Okay, yeah.
Hello, Sharanji, this is Nagraj here. At this point, is it safe to say that the neuter gender words end with the M? Is that
no,
is
no.
It right? No,
it's not like that. No.
Okay.
Neuter gender words. Original word does it ends with only short vowel. From that we get these derived words. Okay, ma. Can say the derived words of the neuter gender will be ending with makara. Singular. That too for singular. Okay. Okay. We have got the other numbers also. We'll see what it is slowly.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So now so whatever information I gave in between, please keep it in your mind. Okay, so that your understanding, will be in proper, will be in line with what I want to say. Okay, then now the next person, Shantaji, can you read from the next line?
Narikelam, coconut, panasapalam, jackfruit, patalam, rose, bhavanam, house, mitram, friend, yutakam, shirt, lashunam, garlic, lekana peetam, desk, vadanam, face, sweta palam, patram, white paper, svedakam, sweater, haritakam, green leaves.
Okay. Haritakam, original form will be Haritaka. From that we get Haritakam. Svedaka, from that we get Svedakam. I'm just giving some example. Okay. Fine. Now, this is only for our reading. Okay. So, some of the important characters from Mahabharata and Ramayana I have given. So, can quickly read. Nagaraj, can you read?
Yeah.
From the.
Uchaihi. उच्चैः पठत
उच्चैः
ओनली उच्चैः पठत गंगा शंतनु शंतनुः सत्यवती पराशरः
सत्यवती इट इज ई लॉन्ग ई कार
सत्यवती पराशरः भीष्मः चित्रांगदः विचित्रवीर्यः व्यासः Ambika, Ambalika.
Okay, fine. Now, can you tell me what is the original word of the word Parasharaha?
Parashara.
It's ending with A, therefore masculine gender. Okay. What about Ambalika?
It would be
Ambalika.
Ambalika.
Ambalika only.
Same only, right? Ambalika. It's the name of the person. Ambalika is the original form. Okay, now the next person. Garimaji, can you read from the next line on?
Yeah, sure. Dhritarashtra, Panduhu, Gandhari, Kunti, Pritha, Madri, Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakulaha.
Okay, fine. What is the original word of the word Nakulaha?
Nakul.
Nakul.
Nakul, not Nakul.
Nakul.
No, Garimaji will answer. Garimaji will answer.
Nakul.
That's not Nakul. It's not Hindi, right? It's not okay. last vowel. It is Nakula only.
Nakula.
What is the original word of the word Yudhishthiraha?
Yudhishthira.
Yudhishthira. For the word Pritha?
Pritha only. Pritha.
And Kunti?
Kunti. Same.
Same. What about Gandhari?
Gandhari. Same.
Oh, okay. Kunti, that original word ends with what vowel?
Long.
Long vowel. So, long vowel. I said the words ending with long vowel will be in what
feminine.
Gender? Feminine. What about Gandhari? Can you read?
Gandhari. It's like short vowel. E.
So Gandhari. I'm not sure whether Gandhari is short or long. As here it is, I have typed short. So assuming that it is soft, as it is short. Okay. So from that we can understand the feminine gender words can end with short vowel also.
Short vowel also, yeah.
Possible. That's why I said in general, exceptions will be there. Okay. So Gandhari, it is ends with short. Okay. This is, you can note down. So it will come like that. Many words you slowly will come. Okay. Now the next person, Venkateshwaranji. Can you read?
Where do I start? Nakula.
Sahadeva.
Sahadeva. Sahadeva. Sumadra.
Subhadra, not Sumadra.
Sorry. Oh, Subhadra. Abhimanyu. Uttara. Prati Vindaya.
Prati Vindyaha, not Vindaya. Prati Vindyaha.
Vindyaha.
Okay.
Sutasomaha.
Sutasomaha.
Sutasomaha. Shrutakirti. Kirtihi. Shata. Shatanika.
Shatanika.
Shatanika. Shutakarma. Madravadi. Vati.
Madravati.
Madravati.
Okay, fine. Next person now. Vinoji, can you read from the next word? No, next person. Oh. Yeah. Next person. Vinoji. Are you there? Your mic, you may be in mute if you are there. Okay. Next person. Surenderji, can you read?
Yeah. From where should I start?
Parikshita.
Parikshita. Parikshita. Janam Jaya.
Again?
Janam Majaya.
Janam Jaya.
Janam Jaya. Karnaha. Durdanaha.
Durdanaha na.
Duryodhana.
Dushala.
Dushala.
Okay.
Dushasana.
Okay. Dushasana, you have to say. You cannot leave out the visarga.
Yeah, Dushasana.
No, again.
Dushasana.
Okay, fine. Okay. Fine.
The next page.
No, it's okay. Your audio has got problem.
Can I say something like this? I put the earphone.
No, but the noise is there.
Yeah.
Okay, mute your mic. See, here, Dusha, it is this is Dushasanaha. Dushasanaha and Dushala. That Isarga, it is read as though like Shakara. Why we read with that, we will see later. Okay, it is Dushasanaha, Dushala. And note down only the pronunciation. Why we will see later. Dushasanaha, Dushala.
Charanji, Dushala, it's not Dushala, her name Dushala.
It is
only sister Kaura's hair.
No, it is Dushala only, not Dushala.
Okay.
Okay, now we'll see the list of characters from Ramayana. Vidyaji, can you read?
Sure. Ramaha, Sita, Hanuman, Mahaviraha, Anjaneyaha, Marutatmajaha.
There is a background, some Lakshmi. Song is going on your side.
Sorry.
You have to mute that, otherwise... Okay. Next person now, Renukaji, can you read? I'm reading the names from the list of, from the chat box. Renukaji,
Yeah. So I'll read from fifth one?
No, so seventh one.
Seventh one. Lakshmanaha, Ravanaha, Jatayuhu, Dasharataha, Bharatah, Shatrughunah.
Shatru, not Shatrughunah, Shatrughnah.
Shatrughnah, Sugrivah, Indrajitah, Kumbhakarnah, Shurpanaka.
Oh,
it doesn't look like ka. Oh, okay.
That's the another example.
Shurpanaka, Vibhishanaha, Janakaha, Vali, Shabari.
Okay, fine. Now the next person. I'm reading the names only from the chat box. Others are not given the name. So you don't want to read, it's okay. But if any other reason, you can tell me. Okay. If you don't know how to type the name, you can ask. So I have to go back to the first person again. Okay. So Timurji, can you read from 21?
From which one? Where are we?
21.
21. Kausalya. Sumitra. Kaikei. Urmila. Mandavi. Shruta ki rtihi.
Okay, so all these are important characters. So you can go through all the words again, so that you'll be familiar with the words and reading practice. try to read more and more words. Okay. Okay. Now the next person. Simaji, can you read the list of words what you see here? These are the names of the rishis. Simaji, can you read?
Yeah. Angari.
Not Angari. Read again.
How to pronounce that?
You read correctly only, but it is not Angari. What is the last word?
Angara.
Angira.
Angira. Sorry. Agastyaha. Atrihana.
Atrihi. You cannot say that Visarga preceded by E. So Atriha sound will not come. Atrihi. Visarga takes a sound of E. Ihi. Atrihi. Patihi. Kaprihi. Right?
Okay. Bharadwaj.
Not Bharat. Is it Ba?
Bharadwaj. Brigu.
Bharadvajaha. Yes.
Bharadvajaha. Briguha.
No, not Briguha. Like Atrihi. Here it will be.
Sorry?
Atrihi. It is not Atriha. Similarly, it is not Briguha. What is that?
Brigu.
Brigu.
Briguhu. Briguhu.
Sarga takes the sound of hu. Okay. Preceding vowel, right?
Briguhu. Durvasaha. Jaiminihi.
Again?
Jaiminihi.
Again?
Jaiminihi. Jaiminihi.
All the names are rishis. It's very, auspicious to recall the names of the rishis in the morning. Jaiminihi.
Jaiminihi. Jabalihi.
Okay. Next line.
Jarutkaru.
It is Jarut.
Jaratkaru.
Yeah. Jarat Karuhu.
Jarat Karuhu.
Okay.
Kashyapaha.
Okay, fine. Now the next person. Bhuvaneshwari.
Kraustuki. Yeah. Kraustukihi. Marichihi. Naradaha. Parasharaha. Pulastyaha. Sharbangaha. No, Sharabangaha.
Sharabangaha.
Oh, sorry. Sharabangaha. Sukaha. Valmikihi. Vasishtaha. Vyasaha. Vishwamitraha. Yajnavalkyaha.
Yajnavalkyaha. Okay.
Vaishambayanaha.
Vaishampayanaha.
Okay. Vaishampayanaha. Markandeyaha. Gautamaha. Jamadaknihi.
Okay, good. Okay. These are some of the names of the rishis. Okay. I'm giving some important Upanishads and Vedas. Ganesh, can you read the four Vedas?
Vedaha, Yajur Vedaha, Sama Vedaha.
What is the first one?
Rig Vedaha.
Sorry?
Rig Vedaha.
Okay, okay, yeah, I didn't hear it properly. Fine, okay. And last one?
Atharva Vedaha.
Okay, you can read the list of Upanishads.
Ishavasyopanishad, Kenopanishad, Kathopanishad, Prashnopanishad, ಮುಂಡಕೋಪನಿಷತ್, ಮಾಂಡುಕ್ಯೋಪನಿಷತ್, ತೈತ್ತಿರೀಯೋಪನಿಷತ್, ಬೃಹದಾರಣ್ಯಕೋಪನಿಷತ್.
ಐತರೇಯೋಪನಿಷತ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಶ್ಯಾಮ್ಜಿ. ದ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುರಾಣಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್, 18 ಪುರಾಣಸ್.
ಪುರಾಣಾನಿ ಮತ್ಸ್ಯ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಮಾರ್ಕಂಡೇಯ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಭಾಗವತ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಭವಿಷ್ಯತ್ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವೈವರ್ತ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಪುರಾಣಂ, ವಾಮನ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ವರಾಹ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ವಿಷ್ಣು ಪುರಾಣಂ, ವಾಯು ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಅಗ್ನಿ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ನಾರದ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಪದ್ಮಪುರಾಣಂ, ಲಿಂಗಪುರಾಣಂ, ಗರುಡ ಪುರಾಣಂ, ಕೂರ್ಮಪುರಾಣಂ, ಕಾಂದ ಪುರಾಣಂ.
ಓಕೆ ಗುಡ್. So these are the 18 Puranas Vyasa Maharishi wrote. So, okay. So with this, I think we completed the first book. At the end of that book, you will find a list of words. Some more words are there that you can go through that. So all the words you cannot do the reading practice in the class. So that is your homework. You have to read the words. A list of words, what you see. You can read and identify the gender of these words. You have got some idea now how to determine the gender of the word. You can go through these words and identify the gender, and also you can be familiar with the meaning of the words. Okay, so that is with this. This is part is completed, and before we conclude today's class, I'll take some more time. I'll quickly go through sutra. It's a sutra, but I didn't mention it's a sutra. It is there in the beginning itself. That talks about the pronunciation, space of pronunciation, uchcharana sthanam. Sorry. Okay. This is the one. Pronunciation guide, what you say. Really, what it written is, it's a sutra only. This is the set. I have written few sutras. We will see in detail later. This is Paniniya Shiksha Sutra. The sutra talks about the pronunciation, place of pronunciation of the letters. Okay. So I'll ask Joji, can you read this, the first one, what I'm highlighting now? You can see.
ಅಕುಹ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನಾಂ ಕಂಠಃ.
ಗುಡ್, ರೀಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್.
ಅಕುಹ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನಾಂ ಕಂಠಃ.
ಅಗೇನ್ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ಲಿ.
ಅಕುಹ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನಾಂ ಕಂಠಃ.
ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೂತ್ರ. ಅಕುಹ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನಾಂ ಕಂಠಃ. ಅಕುಹ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನಾಂ ಕಂಠಃ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸೂತ್ರಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮೆಮರೈಸ್ಡ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಎನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಎಫರ್ಟ್. ಕೀಪ್ ಯು ನೋ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯರ್ ಮೆಮರಿ. ಅಕುಗ ವಿಸರ್ಜನೀಯಾನ ಕಂಠ. ಕಂಠ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೋ, ಕಂಠ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್, ಥ್ರೋಟ್. ಕಂಠ ಇಸ್ ಥ್ರೋಟ್. ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಥ್ರೋಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಥ್ರೋಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊನೌನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್. for what letters? These letters. A. The first letter is A. A is the vowel whose place of pronunciation is the throat. That is what A is there. So short vowel A. It stands for the long vowel also. When you say A, A also to be understood. So A, A. You be with me. Try to follow me. Okay. Then the next letter is Ku. What is Ku? Joji, what is Ku?
All the words from the class of Ka.
All the letters of the class consonant of the class Ka, Kavarga. That is
Kavarga.
Ku stands for Ka, Ka, Ga, Ga, Na. Na. Okay, the fifth one, nasal. So these five letters of the first class, they also, the place of pronunciation is throat. Sorry. So Ku. Okay, so now A, Ku, we have seen. What is the next letter, Joji?
Ha.
Is it Alpaprana or Mahaprana?
Mahaprana.
Mahaprana. What letter is that? And in consonant, in what classification it will come? Remember?
Sibilant.
Good. Ushmanaha. So it is Ushmanaha Mahapranaha. And it is a soft aspirate. If you remember, Mrudu, it is Mrudu Vyanjanani, but Mahaprana. Its place of pronunciation also throat. Okay, from the throat only the sound comes. That is why it is a guttural. So ha. The next one is Visarjaniya. What is Visarjaniya? Visarga. Both are same. Visarjaniya is another word for Visarga. You know what Visarga is. So both are same. Visarjaniya, Visarga, same. So everything put together now in the form of a sutra. Akuha Visarjaniya na. Sorry. Akuha Visarjaniya na kantaha. The letter A, which stands for itself and also its long form. Ku, the particular class, which stands for, which consists of all the five letters. Ha, that we know it's a sibilant. And Visarga, all these four are gutturals. Its place of pronunciation is throat. So, Akuga Visarjaniyanam. Kantaha. This is a simple sutra. Okay. So, instead of mentioning all the five letters of the Kavarga by simply saying Ku, all the five letters are understood. A, Ku, Ha, Visarjaniya, Naam. So you can understand like this. A and Ku and Ha, Visarjaniya, Naam, Kantaha. You can remember, if you memorize this, then you know what all the guttural letters, that which comes from the throat. Okay. Now the next person, Sundarji, can you read the next sutra?
Ichuya Shanam, Talu.
So what is the first letter?
E.
That stands for?
E and E.
Both the short as well as the long. And what is the next one?
Ch. That is ch, ch, j, j.
And nya also. Nasal.
Yeah, sorry.
Next one?
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. What is its place of pronunciation?
Palatal.
Palate. And what's the next one?
Sha.
Sha. Yes. Here is Sha, it is there, but that is some language, Sanskritam, that you will see. Sha letter is there. Sha. Sha. Sha is what?
Sha is, we call it
sibilant. Ushmanaha.
Sibilant. Yeah. Ushmanaha.
So ichyashanam talu. Talu means palate. So the letters E, which stands for its long form also, and Chu, Chavarga, and Ya is a semi-vowel, and Sha is a sibilant. All these four are palatals. Ichyashanam talu. So you can remember this also. Akuka visarjaniyanam kantaha. Ichyashanam talu. Okay. Now the next sutra. Shantaji, can you read the next one?
Ruttu.
Charanji, one question.
Shalam. Murda.
1 minute. Somebody is asking one question. Yeah.
Yeah. Charanji, this is Venkateshwaran. Talu is Talu or Talu?
Talu only.
Talu.
Talu, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Sorry, go ahead.
Shantaji.
Ruttu Shalam. Murda.
Hmm.
Ru.
The first one is the vowel ru. So it stands for ru. Yeah, ru. Both. Okay. Next one.
Okay. Tavarga. Tata, dada, na.
Okay. Next one.
Repa.
Okay. Good. Next one.
Sha.
It is from the sibilant, Ushmana.
Sibilant. Right?
So you will find the vowel first, then the class consonant will come, then semi-vowel will come, then one letter from the sibilant. So Rutu Rashana Murda. So the letters R stands for itself and as well as its long form, and T is a Tavarga, and Ra, that is a Repa, which is its semi-vowel, and Murdanya, Sha, that sibilant. All these are Murda. Murda is the roof of the mouth. Cerebrum. And the pronunciation which comes with the help of that place, it is Murdha, Murdhanyaha cerebrals. So Rutu Rashanam Murdha. So we have seen three sutras now. So you can easily know the Uchcharana Sthanam if you remember these. Okay. Okay, now the next one, Nagaraji. Can you read? Nagaraj, are you there? Your mic may be in mute if you are there. I think it's not there. Okay, the next person now. Garimaji, can you read?
Ratul Sanam Dantaha.
It is again. What is it?
Ratul Sanam Dantaha.
No, it is Lutu. Lutu Lasanam Dantaha.
Ratul Sanam.
No, this is, what is the first letter?
R.
What is that? It's a vowel.
R.
No. You don't have to struggle so much to say that. No, it is simple. It is L. L.
L.
Yeah, it is L. Different from R. It is not a vowel. It's not a consonant. It's a vowel. L.
L.
L. Okay. Lutu Lasanam Dantaha.
I'm sorry, I still didn't get it. L. L.
It is L. You have to go back to the first previous classes, first class. We talked about this pronunciation and all. So,
yeah.
Lutu Lasanam Dantaha. So, the Lu is the vowel. And what is its long form?
L.
What is its long form of L?
Long form of L.
Anyone? Others can unmute the mic and answer.
There is no long form, right?
Yeah, there is no long form. It's no long form. So it's a twist, okay? So don't look for the long form.
Oh, okay.
If you don't have long form.
Okay.
You remember how many short vowels are there? How many short vowels, how many long vowels? I have said this many times in the beginning. That is why I go slowly, repeat what I said many times so that it will sink in your mind. What? How many short vowels are there?
Nine.
No, how many vowels are there in the language? Others also can answer. Unmute the mic, okay? How many vowels in total?
13 plus 2.
So 13 plus 2, okay. How many? Okay, let us say 13. How many short vowels? Without
suffering four. Five.
Four.
Four
or five?
Four.
Five.
It is five, not four.
Eight four. Long vowels.
13 minus 5. How many short long vowels now?
Eight.
What are the five short vowels?
A, E, O.
Then?
A, E, O, R, L.
Okay, fine. And what are the long vowels? A, E, O, R. There is no L. Okay, after that, A, I, O, O comes.
A, I, O. There is
no long form for L. Remember, that's important.
Okay, thank
there
you.
May be a Devanagari script for the long form, but in Sanskritam we don't say that L has got long form. No.
In Devanagari there is no R. That's why it's no, very hard.
Devanagari it is there. It is there. In Hindi it is not there. In Hindi you don't use it probably. But
yeah, Hindi.
Devanagari script it is there.
Okay.
Devanagari script we are there is a long L also. In Sanskritam it is not there. Please understand the difference.
Okay.
Sanskritam uses Devanagari, but doesn't mean all the script of Devanagari should Sanskritam be using. Sanskritam doesn't have long L. It is not there.
L.
Okay. Some people say it is there, some in book. No, it is not there. It is there. To say not there, I have got the Pramanam. Shastra Pramanam is there. I can say with that it is not there. But to say it is there, what is the Pramanam? What is the proof? No proof. So it is not there. Okay, fine. So L is a short vowel. There is no long L. Okay. What is the next letter?
Tu. So ta varga.
Okay.
Ta tha da dhana.
What is the next letter?
L.
What is the next one?
Sa. So sana.
Sa is it's a dental. Sibilant. Yes. So okay. Lutula sanam dantaha. Danta means danta. Teeth. Daha is teeth. Danta is tooth. Dantaha, teeth. Plural. So, Lutulasanam, Dantaha. These letters, these four letters, L, Tu, La, Sa, they come, they are pronounced with the help of the teeth. Therefore, they are dentals. Lutulasanam, Dantaha. So, you can remember these four sutras now simple. Akuga Visarjaniyanam, Kantaha. Ichu yashanam talu, rutu rashanam murdha, rutu lasanam dantaha. See, we know the place of pronunciation. We have seen that before. Now in the form of a sutra we are saying, because you can read now comfortably Sanskrita words and the sentence. So that is like a, so therefore we are going back and reading these Sanskrita sentence. So even though I have given in the beginning, it would not have been possible for you to read it comfortably. But now you can read. Now you can read and you can memorize this. This is a simple sutra. Okay. Four sutras. The next two are there. That would take some time to explain. So I will do it in the next class. What is that? I'll give some more like this. One more is missing here in the list. So I'll give that later. Okay, so we'll stop here. So these four sutras you can remember, you can go through that. So it's easy to remember. Okay, we'll stop our class here, today's class. If you have any doubts, you can ask me.
Sharanji,
yes.
In that PDF file, you have sent workbook to up to 72 pages. So the rest of this is not in PDF. Can you arrange to send it also?
The rest of this, it means workbook 2.
2 and 3 you sent first in docx.
Uh-huh.
Up to the second book you send it in PDF. That workbook 2.
Okay.
That contains only 72 pages.
Probably only that much, I think. 1 minute, let me check up. It is, what is the last, okay. Okay, we'll talk about it after the class.
Okay, you can just check and like,
no? Yeah, you just be on the line, no? Yeah, I'll tell you what it is. I think it is only 72 pages.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, all the, no, the so many words are there, starting with, you know, every letter and its consonant vowel combination. And its meaning is given at the end of the book. Do you find the meaning at the end of the book?
No, I haven't taken a printout of the book, but it says 72 pages. The second workbook says 72 pages, PDF only, file.
Yeah, only 72 pages. Yeah, only.
That's all. Huh? Okay, yes. Okay.
The last page, you will find a list of words. No, the and meanings will be given. Yeah.
Okay, I'll check and come back. Yeah, okay.
It's only 72. Yeah.
Okay. Last word is Gyanendriyani.
Yeah, it's good. Yes, you can again. That book is last page has got a lot, so many words are there. You can go through the words for your abhyasa, reading practice as well as writing. So many of the words what I've given in that we use in our Vedanta class.
Okay.
Like Gyanendriyani and all those things that would be useful. So you can go through that.
Okay.
You've got a lot of homework now. Now on your side, reading practice. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So we cannot read all the words in the class. So with this today's class, we complete our reading of words. Next class, we will read some simple shloka. We'll take simple words and we'll read it. Let us see how you read it. So next class will be the last class for the level one. After that, we'll move on to the level two. So before that, you have to be comfortable reading the words, right? So make sure that you are comfortable with reading the words. So that purely depends on your abhyasa, reading practice. So level two, we'll get into a bit of grammar and other things, right? So if you have any doubts, you can ask me now. Any doubts? You can unmute your mic and ask. Hello. Any doubts? You can unmute your mic. Yes or no? I don't know. I'm not getting any.
As of now, no doubts, Sharanji. We'll
no doubts,
and then come back to you if there is any doubt.
Okay. So we'll stop our class here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Thank you. Please do the reading practice.